everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports.
In today's game, time of possession should be a factor. The Bills are top 10 in converting third down opportunities, and they'll be up against that Jets defense looking to knock that conversion rate down. So for the call of this Week 13 matchup, let's bring in our commentary team of Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL, the National Football League, is here and on the air. Tonight, we wrap up the first 13 weeks of the season with a good Monday nighter between the New York Jets and the Buffalo Bills. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And the reception made by Dante Moncrief. And he's brought down after a good gain. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And on this first drive, looks like they want to get that vertical passing game going early.
And they did, and what a warning shot they just fired. If you're not going to back up and play coverage deep, we're going to attack you all game long. And once you adjust to that and you start to back off, then that opens things up underneath. A really nice start for them. Great way to get the game going.
All right, here we go. Green 39! Green 39!
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a pickup of 14 there. And it's first down, New York.
Effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
And on the ground they go with the running back. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. So just 1 yard to go here on third down.
No, 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 no. Check. Patriots, go. Patriots. Blue landed. Blue landed. Here we go.
They'll set up a throw. And he's got a noon one. He needed a yard. That's what he got. And it's going to earn him a new set of downs. And there on third and short, they just tried to spread the field. It worked.
And I think that the spreading of the field, the extra receivers, has really become the next in the evolutionary chain in the NFL. Go all the way back in that situation, you're handed to the fullback, right? As we evolved, maybe you pitched it to your tailback. Now you spread the field, and you have your choices of where to throw it and complete it for a first down.
Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, surveying the field, and his throw here is incomplete. The intended target, the tight end, Austin Seferian Jenkins. That takes us from second to third down. Quickly now, a look at the Buffalo defense.
Marcel Darius, year in and year out, plays at a Pro Bowl level.
Let's go!
Out of the gun now on third down. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that one incomplete. Had some position, but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. It's a high kick and hit pretty well. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Here's the offensive unit, and heads up, look out for the Clemson Tiger.
Sammy Watkins was brought in to make plays. That's what he specializes in, out on the perimeter or going inside.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Back to throw here. It's complete to his tight end, Charles Clay. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
To throw now on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
Come on, let's go! One.
Here's the first carry for LeSean McCoy. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big time play there.
Back to throw now on second and 10. He's going to look deep down the field into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Calvin Pryor. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got time. He'll rifle this one into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. And the Bills getting set to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Throw now on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Calvin Pryor. Accelerating, and off he goes. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a jet touchdown.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought? That had to be. Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked up that pass?
The free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, oh, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
Here's Percy Harvin now on the return. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Back onto the field now comes the Bills' offense. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high-percentage throws early. To let him get settled back in.
But they told us they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
He's going to air one out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. And a look now at how the Jets line up defensively.
Calvin Pryor's exactly what you're looking for in a safety who polices the middle of the field.
They come up in an offset eye. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
And the Jets, D, they call on a couple extra defensive backs on third. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. Watkins alone on the left side. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Clay. 14 yards there on the pickup, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
Now a first down carry here for McCoy. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Bills in possession. They've got it second and 10 to start things out. Sammy Watkins, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
Single. Here we go. Try at 38.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. Jordan Jenkins able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be fourth down. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Now that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second down following the run. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. The play clock's running down. He'll look to throw. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and get some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
In motion left goes Moncrief. Out of the gun now on third down. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to let it go deep right sideline. So they took a shot there on third down. Couldn't get it. Now it's fourth. A third down. He tried to stay in bounds. Did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And here's a fair catch taken at about the 24-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. 1 man in the backfield. That's McCoy. He's going to get the football. And he'll wind up with about 6 up past the 30 to the 31.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Come on, let's go!
Again, it's McCoy. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up to play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
And this is caught by Watkins. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation. Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
On second down, it's McCoy. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who you know and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
He'll drop to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And now following the incomplete pass, we'll get a timeout here for an injured player. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. And on 2nd and 10 now.
Here we go. 1-9.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that's caught left side. It's Woods. That catch good for five. It's third down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. They're going to look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Oh, man. For him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. So the scoring drive encompasses nine plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the three and move on. Always better than nothing.
The New York set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Completes it to Moncrief, left side. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. Nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And no room that time. Getting it to about the 46. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They come up in an offset eye. They'll look to throw here. Flush to his right. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet inbounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. A big play there with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one fielded at the five. Stays on his feet. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Bills' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see.
They completed the screen, but one of the things you worry about is can the quarterback get rid of the ball before he's actually tackled? So your offensive linemen have to hold up the rushers a little bit because you want to make sure you keep your guy's jersey clean throughout the game.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
He'll look to throw. That incomplete, crisis averted, almost picked. Instead, second down.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
He'll try again with the arm here. And for the third time here this half, it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here. Looking for Moncrief, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. And now out come the Bills. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Looking again for Watkins, and this time that's complete. 14 yards that time for number 14.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And this is caught inside the 5. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Sammy Watkins hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Bills have cut it to within a score. And he knocks it through. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The New York set to take the field. And 2 picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw 4 or 5 picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
And he finds a man on the crossing route. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second in just about a few inches here. And the offense moving quickly to the line. The play fake. He'll look to throw. He'll buy some time right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
Extra DB on the field for the Bills here on third down.
Yeah, maybe thinking pass. They'll drop the throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
He's got his man on the crossing route. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. to throw now on first down. And complete to Moncrief over the middle. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. A great play there as the first half is winding down. And the Jets are going to add on to their lead. Now the extra point try forthcoming. It's good, and it's 21-10. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's going to float this over the middle, deep. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their 4th pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
And that is incomplete. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Jets on top, as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This one fielded at the 5. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Right side complete. That's Woods. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. And they only need a little bit here. Third down and very short. They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go!
They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
4 down, 4 down. Here we go now. Blue landing.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Well, Brandon, so much for halftime adjustments. They still can't get anything going on the ground. It may be time to loosen things up and start flinging it around a little bit.
A long way to go for the offense here on third down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. And the Bills' offense comes out. Ready to take over. They'll try and get the running game going with McCoy. And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. They got a man over the middle. It's Woods. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. 1 man on the backfield. That's McCoy. They'll look to throw now on first down. Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got him. They'll get 16 yards there. And it'll give the Bills a first down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, incomplete. The defense in an enviable position here. The offense needs 13 yards. It's third down. Now back to throw. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. And then moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. Nope. And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown. It's their quarterback, his 25th touchdown, tying him at Smith for the fifth most in one season. And the Bills draw a bit closer. They'll try and throw for it. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And the Jets set to take the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
In motion left goes Moncrief. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Adolphus Washington in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year.
Detroit! Detroit! Now let's go!
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And here come the Bills. And that last drive, a long drive. But not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Come on, let's go! What?
Back to throw now on first down. This is caught. Watkins. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Sammy Watkins with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Bills have taken the lead. And it's up and good. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Completes it to Moncrief, left side. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line.
That was a nice pickup. Some chunk yardage there. Some of those big yards downfield with a little bit of rack thrown in there, a little run after catch. And it came on a crossing route. I could just hear one of my friends who won 4 Super Bowls as a quarterback always said the same thing. What route does a defense hate? Crossing route. Hate it, hate it, hate it, because it's hard to change direction when they get going full speed in the other way.
Go, 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 go. Final minute now of the third quarter. Now a play fake here on first down. Rolling to his right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Quincy Anunua that time. And that'll bring up second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
And that one pushes the lead up to 11. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The New York set to take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, it didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run.
Here we go now.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
The defense gets to the quarterback that quickly. A lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit, and it forced an incompletion.
Defense has to stand tall here, third and one. He'll drop to throw, and James has it. And the broken tackle helps lead to a first down gain. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. Back now in Buffalo. It's Jet football, but they trail here as we start the fourth quarter. Fresh set of downs here. They'll look to throw again, escaping the pressure right. And complete to Moncrief over the middle. 23 yards on the play. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there. One of the best routes, one of the favorite routes of any play caller. He just ran that one. Nice little angle route. That's supposed to be a catch, and usually it is, and running back dropped it.
Yeah, I mean, he's a running back, but he's got hands. He should have caught it. Back to throw now on second and 10. Moncrief brings it in. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Well, they brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call. When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. So they're operating in the red zone. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That's caught at the one. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Austin Seferian Jenkins, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again. Big play coming now for the Jets as they'll set up to go for two.
Set, green, 39.
They'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And he is all the way up past the 25.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back, get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case here, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside.
Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. So they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense. And they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Man open right side, it's the tight end play. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. A gain of three, second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And he gets it down to the 32. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
There we go, D. That's the way to hit. Come on, let's go.
A give to McCord. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Let's go! One, nine, ten.
Back to throw here. Right side complete. That's Woods. And he's brought down. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
10th carry now for McCoy. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Let's go! One, nine.
They'll look to throw here. They got a man over the middle. It's Woods. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
It's a quarterback sneak. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And now they're in the hurry up.
Oh, yeah, good surge defensively. Sometimes you can just tell by the way a quarterback.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Buffalo. It's their quarterback with touchdown number 27. That ties Priest Holmes for the third most in a single year. And the Bills will add on to their lead.
And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. Now this is picked up, and this is going to be brought back for a Bills touchdown. So they get the one score, kick off, get a fumble, take it right back to the house. Two quick touchdowns within a matter of about 10 seconds on the game clock.
It's like a big 1-2 punch that may lead to a knockout.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This will be fielded at the 6. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The New York set to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. A gain of 4 on the play, and it'll bring up a 2nd down. And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the 2-minute warning. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up. After this. Back to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Call it a loss of 5, a big sack to bring up 3rd down. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
2nd down, sacked by the defense. What type of pressure will they bring here on 3rd? We'll see. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And they're going to speed things up here. To throw now on 1st down. Completes it to Moncrief, left side. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Now let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. To the flat, that's complete to his running back. It'll be a gain of 4, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
All right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. Again, he'll drop to throw. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete.
Zero. We'll be right back.